Hi everyone, welcome to Allied Health 101. In this short video, we're going to take a quick look at the course and get you set up so that you can complete the first week's work, okay? So let me share my screen and here we have the course. We are going to follow the course through modules as you should, but before we get started, let me point out a few things about what you have here, okay? You should begin any course, but this course especially, by reading the syllabus. So if you click into the syllabus link, you'll find the syllabus. The syllabus is quite thorough and introduces you to course objectives and policies, to deadlines and dates, all of that important information. So be sure to read your syllabus. You'll find your classmates here. If you need to contact your classmates, you can actually click into their name and send them an email. Of course, follow your grades as well. We'll be using, or you may be using in your team sites, the discussions, collaborations, and conferencing links. So all of that's important as well. Now, right here on the front of this course, it says, click on modules to the left to begin the course. The best way to make sure you're not missing anything is to always click into the modules. The second most important, maybe the most important, is also to always read your announcements. And I discuss this in the syllabus. After the course begins, I communicate with class announcements. That means you either have to enable them so you get a notification or click into your course and check the announcements daily. All right, course supports for success, all sorts of good stuff. So not only some technology information, but if you need to sign up for a computer, let me know and I will do that for you. We've got tutors and guides, information you will find here as well. And the college has done a fantastic job of enabling all sorts of supports for students. CCP CARES is a kind of emergency fund for students who need something covered that's getting in their way of college success. So that is here as well. And this is where we will meet every Monday at 3:30 as a class. Okay, so you can click through all of this. And remember, this doesn't go away, so you can use it throughout the course. Now, as far as your textbook, when you registered for the course, you were charged a fee, which gave you a very low cost, a really good deal for the textbook and MindTap. The textbook is an e-text. What is neat about this first week is when we talk about the introductory unit, you will learn everything you need to know about registering, no code required, and using the e-text and the MindTap. Some more information here. I'll tell you, this is tech support for Cengage, our textbook company. And here you see that our Cengage learning consultant actually has office hours listed throughout the first 2 weeks. So if you hit a stumbling block and would like to talk to that person, click in here. All right. The first week, okay, in the first week I mentioned we miss Monday and the work is due Sunday, so we don't have a mandatory meeting, but you have work to do. And actually, let's talk a little bit about time in this course. This course is set up for your success, but it also requires a lot of work. It is a type of course where if you put in the time, you will probably do quite well. But if you don't put in the time and you wait till the last minute, you may not do so well. So for the first week, you're going to complete an introductory unit that includes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 graded assignments. This means if you want to stay on track, you should complete an assignment a day. As you move along in the course, remember that for every 3 credits, you need to spend 9 hours, 3 times 3, outside of class working on the course, 9 hours per week. That's pretty standard, and that covers this course as well. The best thing to do is to allocate or schedule in about an hour a day, and then maybe 2 hours on the weekend to work on this course. All right. So for the introductory unit, that's due the day before we meet as a group. You're going to work through each of these assignments. Each of them is different, but covers what instructors believe is the most important information to know before you get started. Keep in mind as well that these assignments require that you practice some of the skills you'll need throughout the course. So in Canvas 101, you will become familiar with Canvas and online learning, and you will submit your assignment as a text entry. For the textbook and MindTap, you're going to learn about how to register for your course and how to use the textbook and MindTap, and you'll take an online quiz on that. For the syllabus, you're going to download your syllabus, and then you'll be led through finding important information which you need to highlight, and then you'll send that back submitted as a Word document. Avoiding plagiarism is a text entry box. This is a matching test, and this last is a discussion. So there's a little bit of genius in here. We're leading you through learning about the important information, but also the types of submissions and assignments that you'll need in the course. Now, when you complete this introductory unit, you can move on to unit one. However, you do not need to do so. We will talk about the work for unit one in our first meeting on Monday. So you can hold on that as well. All right. So I'm looking forward to this semester and meeting all of you. Take care.